In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you always. And good morning. And we are happy to have our school children today with us on this welcome mass. For them, we gathered with their parents, with their teachers, with their principal, and also our young ones, our youth. We welcome them today. Give them a big hand. Today, as you know, is what happened 21 years ago was a dark moment for all of us. And in the gospel today, we are reminded once again of God's love and forgiveness. For the times when we fill our hearts with hate, with resentment and bitterness and ignorance, for those many times, we ask God's mercy and forgiveness.
Lord Jesus, you are the fulfillment of the covenant. Lord, have mercy.
And Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the shepherd who seeks the lost. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the light in our darkness. Lord, have mercy.
And Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. And now let us give thanks and praise and glory to our loving God.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory.
Let us pray. And look upon us, O Lord, our God, creator and ruler of all things, and that we may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that we may serve you with all our heart, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Now, please be seated for the first reading.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Go down at once to your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, for they have become depraved. They have soon turned aside from the way I pointed out to them, making for themselves a molten calf and worshipping it, sacrificing to it, and crying out, "This is your God, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt." I see how stiff-necked this people is, continued the Lord to Moses. Let me alone, then, that my wrath may blaze up against them to consume them. Then I will make of you a great nation. But Moses implored the Lord, his God, saying, "Why, O Lord, should your wrath blaze up against your own people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt with such great power and with so strong a hand? Remember your servants, Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and how you swore to them by your own self, saying, 'I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and all this land that I promised, I will give your descendants as their perpetual heritage.'" So the Lord relented in the punishment he had threatened to inflict on his people. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. A reading from the first letter from St. Timothy. Beloved, I am grateful to him who has strengthened me, Christ Jesus our Lord, because he considered me trustworthy and appointed me to the ministry. I was once a blasphemer and a persecutor and arrogant, but I've been mercifully treated because I acted out of ignorance in my unbelief. Indeed, the grace of our Lord has been abundant, along with the faith and love that are in Christ Jesus. This saying is trustworthy and deserves full acceptance. Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Of these, I am the foremost. But for that reason, I was mercifully treated, so that in me, as the foremost, Christ Jesus might display all his patience as an example for those who would come to believe in him for everlasting life. To the King of ages, incorruptible, invisible, the only God, honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Tax collectors and sinners were all drawing near to listen to Jesus. But the Pharisees and scribes began to complain, saying, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." So to them, Jesus addressed this parable. What man among you, having 100 sheep and losing one of them, would not leave the 99 in the desert and go after the lost one until he finds it? And when he does find it, he sets it on his shoulders with great joy. And upon his arrival home, he calls together his friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found my lost sheep." I tell you, in just the same way, there will be more joy in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who have no need of repentance. Or what woman, having 10 coins and losing one, would not light a lamp and sweep the house, searching carefully until she finds it? And when she does find it, she calls together her friends and neighbors and says to them, "Rejoice with me, because I have found the coin that I lost." In just the same way, I tell you, there will be rejoicing among the angels of God over one sinner who repents. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus. we heard today, rejoice with me. The joy of God when we come home, when we are lost. When we are able to come home in humility, to make that U-turn to God in humility and faith and love. Rejoice with me, the joy of the Father when we come home. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'd like to welcome you today on this very special Mass for our school children and for our children in the youth ministry. I'd like to thank our principal, Miss Natalie Lins Acuña, thank you. And also our youth minister, Tina Posas. Can you please stand, the two of you? Our principal, our youth minister. Thank you for bringing our children to the Sunday gathering. As we know, the Sunday gathering is the high point and the summit of our Christian experience. Whatever we do on Sunday, we do it here. And that's why it's so important to see the children here today, and your pastor is very happy, along with their parents. Can I ask the parents of the school children and the youth to please stand? All the parents of our children and the youth ministry, thank you for bringing your children to us. I hope that this will not be the first time and the last time, but I hope that it will become a Sunday habit for you to be part of this celebration. And of course, you know what happened 21 years ago, why it happened, right? You remember that moment? You remember that moment when that happened, where you were? Do you remember where you were that moment 21 years ago, Kathy?
I was at home watching the morning news.
You were at home watching the morning news. All of us, almost every one of us, those who were born before that, remember what happened that day, where you were. Do you remember where you were? You were not born yet. You were born, yeah. Anyone else, do you remember where you were when that happened? When that attack on America? Maria? You were watching the morning news with the vice principal? Right? And that day, that morning, was a horrific moment. There was our hearts filled with despair, with fear, with anger, right? But I also remember that day, that night, during that Tuesday, that day when it happened, that Tuesday night, I remember this church so filled with people for the candlelight vigil, wall to wall, with everyone holding a candle. I remember that night, this church so filled came to pray, to be with one another in a spirit of love and forgiveness, in a spirit of being one with one another, remembering those who died. And today we remember those who died that day, our brothers, our sisters, parents, grandparents, co-workers, police officers, firefighters, right? We remember them. We remember them today. That's why I'm gonna ask you now to spend a little moment in silence as we remember those who died. If you can just close your eyes in silence, in prayer, and in remembrance. Thank you. And I think that gathering that night, that Tuesday night, 21 years ago, that yes, it was a very dark moment for the world, for United States. But instead of cursing the darkness, we decided, the body of Christ decided to light a candle of hope, of peace, and love, and forgiveness. Rather than cursing the darkness, we, the community of faith here at St. Joseph, decided to light a candle of hope, of peace, and love, and forgiveness. That's what I'm gonna do right now, in memory of those who died, to light this candle, that we, like Christ, will be the light of the world. Christ is the light. But why it happened? Why did that happen 21 years ago? Why? And where do you want to go? What have we learned? What have we learned from this as people? Right? What did we learn? Why it happened? Children, you know why it happened? Fear, okay. Why did it happen? Power, okay, wow. What else? Why did it happen? Why this attack on America happened? Why? Hatred, okay. What else? Anyone else? Why? It happened. There must be a reason why it happened. Remember what St. Paul says? I acted in ignorance. I acted in ignorance. Right? That's what happened. I mean, for us to know a person, then we must let go of ignorance. We must break the barrier, the wall that's standing between us, between people. That barrier has to come down so that we can know each other. It happened because of ignorance that led to hatred. That's what happened. right? Why is it that, like what happened in 1800s, the Jim Crow, why it happened? Do you know why it happened? Again, hatred and ignorance. The internment of the Japanese Americans. Why did it happen? You learn about this, right? Yes. You speak louder. Ignorance, yes. I mean, everything's about ignorance, right? Not knowing who your neighbor is, right? Do you know your neighbor right now? Do you know who is next to you? Do you know your neighbor seriously, right? Do you know the person next to you, right? So I'm going to ask you now to turn around and go to the person that you don't know and introduce yourself, talk to each other. Talk to your neighbor. Please do that in right now. Talk to your neighbor. Do not talk to the person that you know. I'm going to introduce to you my new friend, Victoria. Okay? I just made a new friend, Victoria, from our school. Get to know your neighbor, my friends. Bring down the barriers, the wall that is keeping us from knowing each other. That's the reason why it happened. When are we going to learn as people? As students of God, as Christians, when are we going to learn how to live with one another in peace, in love, in harmony, in forgiveness? That is the call of the gospel today. Love and the forgiveness of God, right? Love and the forgiveness of God. The gospel must be our guide. It must be our guide in our journey. Like St. Paul, it became his guide as he journeyed, as he proclaimed the gospel of Jesus. He said, I acted in ignorance first. That's why everything was in darkness. I put people to death, to prison, because I was so ignorant, right? There's so much ignorance that leads to hatred. And when your heart is filled with hate, what happens? Love cannot enter. Love cannot enter if your heart is filled with hatred and ignorance. Love cannot enter. And we don't want this to happen again, my friends. We must be awakened. As a nation, as people, we need to be awakened. We need to ask that question. As a Christian, right? As a Christian, do I live my Christian faith with love, with responsibility, with respect, and with reverence? We have lost those words in our society. The world has become so arrogant and so violent. You know, I'm so scared sometimes when I walk on the streets of Pinoy or any street. There's fear in me that someone's going to punch me from the back or even standing in the BART station because of my color. How can we learn? That is not the right thing to do in response to what's happening in the world. We must change. We must be transformed. We must believe that only love can change everything. Right? What have you learned? What have you learned from this? Love with all your heart. Right? forgiveness. Jesus came to overpower hate with forgiveness, right? And remember the words of Martin Luther King. What did he say? That when we are hurt, he said, that we must be the first one to make the first step to reconciliation. Do not wait, but make that first step to reconciliation. What happened 21 years ago changed everyone's life and the world. But have you changed? Have you come home to the forgiveness and the love of God? Right? Look at the mirror today. And when you go out today, when you go out every day from your home, am I going to be, ask that question, am I going to bring hope in the world that is in despair? Am I going to bring love to the person that I met? Ask that question, because when that happens, then the world will be different. Will be a place of peace and joy and happiness and harmony. Right? And yet, so many of us, we proclaim that I am a Christian, and yet I'm filled with hate. How could you say you're a Christian? I'm Catholic. And then we are so filled with hate and ignorance. Is the person next to you worthy of love? Yes. Right? Worthy of love. Because God loves us no matter what. You know this? What is this? How much is this? $20, right? Do you want this? Do you want this? No or yes? Who wants a $20 bill? Right? Okay. Thank you. If I'm going to do this, step on it. Spit on it. Do you still want it? Do you still want it? Right? Do you still want this? So many times because of sin, of our action, that we put ourselves in that situation. Dirty, in isolation. And yet, no matter what, my friends, no matter what, God still loves me. God still wants me. God still wants me. Right? So we must learn. We must learn how to love like our God. We must learn how to love and to care for one another. That's all I ask from you, my friends, as we gather here today on this anniversary of 911. A day in America we will not forget. Come home. Come home to the love of God and His forgiveness. We must be the light in darkness. We must bring hope to the people of the world. Children, you are the hope of the world. Be the light in darkness. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born the Father of all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation, came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In faith, in hope, and in love, we now offer our prayers to our loving God.
For the Church, Pope Francis, Bishop Barber, and priests throughout the world, that with confidence in the power of God, they may continue to bring a message of the love and peace of God's kingdom to all people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the leaders of the world, that they may work toward justice and peace for all people, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the entire St. Joseph School and parish community, that we continue to live each day with gratitude in our hearts for the blessings we have, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the Holy Spirit may guide all teachers and staff as they strive to inspire, encourage, and challenge their students, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the 8th grade class at St. Joseph School, that we may take time to reflect on our past, experience our present, and plan for our future as we begin our last year at St. Joseph School, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
On this anniversary of the 9/11 attack, we pray for a world riddled with anger, jealousy, and revenge, that conflict may give way to understanding and oppression give way to justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those in our community who have recently passed away, may they feel the grace of the Spirit as they enter the heavenly reign of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the special intentions we hold in our hearts, and for the special intentions of this Mass, for soul of Eduardo Borja Sr., we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. We also remember Joy Chupilas, for her, for the gift new life in the kingdom, and for Ron Acuna on his birthday today, 16th birthday. Happy birthday, Ron. 16, plus tax. Yeah. Happy birthday. And God, most loving Father, we come before you in thanksgiving for the gift of your Son. Be with us as we offer it today, our prayers in thanksgiving and humility and faith. We ask this with confidence through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. And by the way, there will be a second collection for the priest's retirement. Thank you so much. After communion. Thank you. My friends, we pray now that my sacrifice and yours may be pleasing to God, the Almighty Father. And look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness, accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in you we live and move and have our being, and while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the place of life eternal. So with the angels and saints, as in joyful celebration, we now proclaim your glory.
Holy, 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 Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessings. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. And therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking the body and the blood of Christ, We may be guided into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, with John, all the bishops and the clergy. Remember us, our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Today we remember Eduardo Borjas, Sr. In baptism, he died with Christ. And those who have died in your mercy, we also remember Joy Chupelas. In baptism, died in the peace of Christ. Bring her and all the departed who have died. Welcome them into your kingdom of peace and love. But have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, and the blessed apostles, and all your saints, with Saint Anne, Saint Joachim, and those who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Do not be afraid to come home to your Father, whose forgiveness, mercy, and compassion. Do not be afraid to come home. At the Savior's command and from a divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen. And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you.
Let us offer one another a sign of God's peace.
Peace to all of you and those who are watching at home. Peace to all of you. Peace.
Thank you.
peace. My friends, behold Jesus, who revealed to us love, the love of God and His forgiveness. And happy are those who are called to this supper. Lord, I am not worthy, should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and the blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. Amen. Thank you. Again, now we have now the second collection for all the retired priests of the diocese. And as you know, that we have so many of them now in different homes in the diocese. And they have served the church, they have served this diocese, and we owe them a lot. So please be generous in giving. And may the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. As you know, in 2 weeks' time, we will celebrate our 75th anniversary as a community, and through the year, during the early months of this month, of this year, we have been showing you pictures of the past and the present and the future. So, sister, thank you. I had no idea that the Pope came to St. Joseph. But again, join us for our celebration this coming in 2 weeks' time for our 75th anniversary celebration. It's starting on Friday the 23rd at 6 o'clock with evening prayer. And then at 7 o'clock, we have the 75th anniversary concert. My friends, our artists here at St. Joseph, they have been preparing for months so that they can give you a wonderful concert. Please come. Please appreciate them. They have been spending a lot of time. Be here. Be part of this celebration. They have been spending a lot of time. I hope that we can take some of your time to be here. Right, Madam Principal? Yes. Our Assistant Principal will be here. Okay. And of course, and then on Saturday, the Saturday the 24th, the multicultural celebration, again with food, drinks, dancing, singing. There's going to be a lot of that on Saturday. And then the big one on Saturday, with our bishop coming here presiding at the 12 noon mass. This is so important that we need to show our support, your appreciation. And to thank God for those who have been here for many years, those who work so hard so that we can be here to celebrate and to be able to come to worship God. So I would like to honor those who are here today who have been here almost since the beginning of time, for those over 40 years, 50 years, 60 years, to please stand if you have been here for those many years. Please stand so that we can give you thanks for all your work. Thank you so much. We will never forget your energy, your dedication, and everything that you have done. You are the pioneers of this community. So thank you so much. Thank you for your love. And by the way, the shrine is almost finished. So if you want to see the shrine of Mary and Joseph, the bishop will bless that shrine before the Mass on that Sunday, the 25th. Okay, so more announcements. Of course, the Oktoberfest will be on the 15th and the 16th of October, and more information will come. And then next, of course, the bricks. If you have not gotten one of the bricks, this is now the time. We are almost putting everything together for that day when the bishop will be here. Next. Okay, and then faith formation registration. It will end on September 30th, so please register your children. Go to the office or you can go to our website. Next. And confirmation, second year, grades 10 to 12, required for students and parents today. And every Sunday? Tina? No? Just today? 5 months. Can you please? Once a month. Thank you. Twice a month. Okay. Thank you. And then next? And then youth ministry, first year, grade 9 to 12, again, required for students and parents, starting this Monday on September 12th at 6:30 p.m. Okay, first year, and then Spanish, again, right over there. Read it. 1, 2, 3, finish. Next. Again, this one again, faith formation, 1 to 8, again, on starting this Wednesday, September 14, in the church. Required for students and parents. Next. RCIA. I've been talking about the RCIA. If you're baptized Catholic but not confirmed, this is your program. You know who you are. Okay? And Ron, happy birthday tomorrow. I think, yeah. Again, I would like to thank again our servers, to Ricky, to Pia, to Alcid, to Zia, their daughter, to Michael Chio, to our usher, Sister Celine, our Eucharistic ministers, to our wonderful lectors, to our children who proclaim the word, thank you so much. And to all of you that came today, thank you so much. Again, thank you so much. I have written an article in the bulletin. Please read that. This is about, again, what happened 21 years ago. Please read it. And again, to our principal, to our vice principal, and to the faculty and staff of St. Joseph, thank you for being here, supporting our children, and to the youth ministry, to Tina. I'm going to ask that the catechist of our youth ministry, confirmation, please stand if you are here. Our catechist, youth ministry, confirmation, if you are here, can you please stand? Here they are, so give them a big hand. Thank you so much. Again, come home. Do not be afraid when you are lost. Come home to God. Please stand. And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may God bless us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve our God and one another.
Thanks be to God. Happy Sunday. If there is forgiveness in our heart, let there be peace on earth. God bless America.
To take each moment.